This could just... Yep, stop frames, detected 70% a few seconds ago. Well, this is infuriating. I don't know whether to not stick it out or... it doesn't really count. Also, why the hell?
I could get it by myself.
Shut up. Oh well. Copyright strike. Raiders over Broncos. We won the last game. Been a while, and we're one game out of first, so, breakout teammate. Yeah, you sucked, so. Yeah, blow me. Alright. We beat the Broncos, it was great. They're 2-9, no big deal. It's time to upgrade this player. Field general. Bloop. Blitz radar. That's interesting. Just 69. Nice. Abilities. Alright, let's play the Falcons. We should win this one. Based on records. I think we can do this. Wait a minute. Let's not play this game. Using the keyboard, because that would be insane. Okay, settings. Game controls. Not what I mean. Options. Also, not what I mean. Accessibility.
Entering settings screen, you have 19 options. Menu narration option is set to off is selected.
Season game. Don't want. Well, let's just hope it figures things out when we get there, because if I try to play this using the mouse, then it's going to be frustrating for all involved. Alright, we're doing anniversary home. Y'all doing color rush. All right, let's just do this. Drop all the frames in the meantime. so frustrated with this. No, I don't.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach.
Shut up, you're not a coach. And this is already jittery and infuriating. And we're already down by 7 points, so yay.
First carry for Josh Jacobs, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just okay, a three-yard gain there. Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Here's a second and seven. The open man here, Renfrow. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That goes for a gain of 31.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. It was Ricardo Allen there on the coverage. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Open man is Uzama. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A well-executed 22-yard gain. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Second and two. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on third and two. Now a give, right side. It's Green. And he'll be driven back here. Loose.
Wait. Oh my God. We made it.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. They'll run it with Jacobs. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll make it third and goal. Line of scrimmage at the 4. Here's third and goal. They'll run with Jacobs. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be a...
Oh, we somehow got a touchdown out of that. And so did they. So right back to where we
Let's go, let's go, let's go. For 50.
They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. He's going to look deep down the field. It's caught inside the 25. That catch for his career is number 731, and that's the number that Calvin Johnson ended with when he stopped his career in 2016.
Yeah, what could it?
That is caught by Brown. Touchdown, Raiders. Antonio Brown.
Ah. Okay. Looks like we need to get all the touchdowns.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from our... here today.
Sorry,
we get slap happy up here sometimes. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now back to throw. They'll roll him out right. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And the young Bucks showing that ability, that agility to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second that the coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerate a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks and they get outside of the pocket, you're just hoping that they make good decisions because so many things can happen that can go wrong. When you
a battle for it, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get...
Okay. Oh, wait. How did we get them called back? I don't care. Let's just...
Here we go. Set. 18 Gator. And go.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Okay, that was dumb.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. They'll look to throw to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Really?
The turnover put them in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad. Yeah. They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Fine, we'll take the three. Oh, and we got it back. I'm surprised. And we have... one timeout. Okay.
Red, eight, three. I'm here all day. I'm here all day.
Who am I?
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's going deep for Brown. It's caught inside the 25. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17.
Oh, we're kicking now. Okay. Whatever. Couldn't have let me take one shot into the end zone. Hike the ball, please.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. And he takes it up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about 4.
Defense.
Made you look.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. This will be caught by Brown. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run it with Jacobs. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Now, throw to the end end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Oops, I didn't mean to do that.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Second and 10. That's going to be caught by Williams for a Raiders touchdown. Tyrell Williams, his third touchdown now on the year as they have taken the lead. Now the Raider offense will stay out there as they'll line up to go for two. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that's the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season.
Yes, well. Can we hold them? Yeah, real quickly. Yeah.
Ready. Nice.
We'll take three.
On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. They're going to look to throw. Got his man. That's Tyrell Williams. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. This quarterback now right at the 300-yard mark with still a quarter plus to go. It's first and 10. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to our 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in his performance.
Why are you hurting?
After the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll take a break and get a report from Oakland after this. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. They'll look to throw here. Steps away to his left. And the Raiders are in for 6. Touchdown. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Raiders able to extend.
Hey, if you're going to play that deep, I'm going to take it. Oh, look at this. Look at this. We've got five.
Red. 8-3. You get me? He's not going to get me? Hey, check my 45. Check my 45.
Three butts.
They'll run on first down. Jacobs. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here. And a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask.
We'll take it.
Trailing in the 4th this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. A 1st down run, good for about 3. 2nd and 7 coming up. Ricardo Allen, the safety, makes the stop. On 2nd down, it's Jacobs. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use time?
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Deidre Sinat with a sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no glass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You talk about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first. They will run the draw with Jacobs. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Once again, it's Jacobs. And they'll lose yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a third down. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. We've got a one-score game with inside of...
Kick it. No? Holy crap. All right.
So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On first down, it's Jacobs. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. The Falcons is going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll keep it on the ground. Jacobs. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs.
All right. We'll take that, and we'll take the ball back. Thank you. How did we get the ball here? I don't know. I don't care. We'll just roll it in.
Here's Jacobs.
Or not.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ball game.
Okay, can I make a jump now? Ready, go. No.
One more time with Jacobs. And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown.
Great job. Touchdown for Dave.
Yeah, touchdown for Dave.
They'll run on first down. It's Jacobs, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Give him 12 yards that time, and an Oakland first down. On first down, they go with Jacobs again. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
Face mask. Defense.
Oh, hey, game can't end on a defensive penalty, can it? Uh-huh.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
The penalty moves them into the red zone here on first and 10.
Yes, let's do this.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Crap. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they?
No,
I mean, what
can.
A game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Oakland.
They're still from Oakland. And that in itself is a tragedy. Really an existential nightmare. Oh, but look at all the XP. Woo, woo, woo. Okay, still got 4 more games to pick up some points. The Patriots. I can't wait. Tom Brady. Blah, blah, blah. Yes, whatever. Tom Brady. Oh, I just want to beat Tom Brady with an iron pipe. Okay, and the good news is we can make them wear some decent uniforms for a change. So, let's just... Ba-ba-ba-da-ba. Anniversary away. CPU. Classic home. Yeah. Oh, I'm afraid to even see how many frames we have dropped tonight. Oh, look who has more passing yards. I have a stronger arm than you. I'm so mighty. Antonio Brown, you've lost a great deal of points. Okay. No, just don't say anything. Just don't. Hey! Our defense seems to have held them. Who would have thought? Josh? Counterplay. Impress me.
First rep of the game for Josh Jacobs. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down. North of 100 yards, the two scores, and, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to the O-line. We talked a lot about him, but offensive line was good, too.
They're obviously in sync with each other, whether it's zone blocking, power running game, no matter what. He understands how to read them and find the creases that they provide.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Jacobs now. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. They lulled them to sleep there, so to speak. That was all set up by the running game, wasn't it?
Another example of what all offensive coordinators tell us. When the running game's operating, it really opens up the playbook. And that's when they hit them with the play action. And you can see the defenders rushing towards the line of scrimmage, then scrambling back, trying to cover. Couldn't get there in time.
Well scripted. They had the big running play. Now the big passing play. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll set up a throw.
Oh,
trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon.
Oh, for the love of God.
Weaving through traffic, and now he's free.
And
he will score. Touchdown, Patriots.
On the upside, I completed my first touchdown pass. Now we could split hairs about who that pass was intended for.
On first down, it's Jacobs. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Back to throw now on second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing a big way, and what else do you have to look out for?
Okay, not ideal. But we can do this. We're not dead yet.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And his throw is going to be incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. You can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has...
It got his man complete! A game there of 30 big ones. The Raiders with the football here to begin quarter number two as they've got it with a first and 10. The Raiders with the football here to begin quarter number two. They'll run on first down. It's Jacobs. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. On second down, Jacobs. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Brown, his first catch. It's a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to throw here. Going for it all. And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. C.J. Uzama.
All right, we're back in. Okay, we're not back in it anymore. We had a minute.
Back to throw. He's going to find and complete it to Renfro. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A Raider first down, 17 yards. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid-type player. Half defensive back that covers passes, and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Yeah. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Let's go. Okay. How did this happen? Don't know. Don't care.
On first down, it's Jacobs. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 11. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
A chance now to get even before the break as they come up 1st and goal. Running the toss here to Jacobs. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. He lost 6 there on the first down play. Here's a 2nd and 7. Sliding out of the pocket. This is caught. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right.
And we're going to kick. Okay. I respect that.
On the ground, Jacobs will get the 3rd quarter started. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. 2nd and 6.
I have to think of major focus of the halftime.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders.
Tyrell Williams.
His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Raiders have taken the lead. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play. And just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
Yeah, I'm dwelling on this. I'm sorry. And just like that, we're losing again. Okay.
Ready. Nice.
Ready.
Cool. Zomar. They're on 1st down. It's Jacobs, and that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped to the backfield. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down. Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. He'll look to throw.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put it up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well. Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come.
Yeah!
Get incomplete. My hands
again. Love a guy. And just like that, we're losing even more. For the love of God. God.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Going for the deep ball. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Duke Dawson picks it. And he'll bring this all the way.
That was a risky maneuver running by the enemy.
Intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker Kyle Van Noy. And his guys will.
That was not my damn fault. All the others, yes. Not that one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
I'm not even sure I know who this guy is out there playing right now. This is very unlike him. One of the most accurate guys in the league. Totally off his game right now.
I was going to ask you what you pin it on, but defensively, they've been pretty solid.
Well, sometimes, you know, those defenders, they get into the receivers pretty well, and if they chip away at their timing, it's going to affect what you're doing there on the ball as well.
And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. He'll drop to throw.
Okay, come
on. He's going to go down again. Lightning speed there on the sack from the corner, Duke Dawson. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Hey, normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. But he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And no, it's incomplete. The Raiders try it on fourth down.
No! Fine, I'm going to go down swinging.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now back to throw. Flushed out right. He's going to let it fly.
Okay.
And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long
one.
That was
not good protection. It was just that I moved the ball.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. They'll drop the throw. Oh. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense is well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
They'll look to throw.
What a catch and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them.
They got a little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown.
Like I said,
Ben Koyak.
I mean, it's not going to be enough, but.
So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And to the surprise of exactly nobody that watched this game, it was the 40-something.
Just shut up. Okay, that did not help our playoff drive. Win the game? No. Still not up to 4,500 yards. Okay, I don't care. Shut up. It's the Chiefs. Oh my God. Oh, wait. I need to play this game. At least I'm not being taunted by Patrick Mahomes or anything. Edit unis. Anniversary away. Oops. Anniversary home. CPU. Anniversary away. Let's do it. You know, we didn't come back all the way, but we had a decent drive at the end, and I'm not happy, but I am content. No, I am. I just am. Sometimes just existing is the greatest pain of all. The horror. The horror. Anyway.
A fight.
Shut up. Let's go. Outside zone. Do it. Oh God, this is not gonna work.
On first down, it's Jacobs.
Oh,
and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
Okay, so this game is off to a
first play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Here we go on second and 12. Wide open receiver complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Solid gain of 18 and a Raider first down. They're going to look to throw.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Second and 10. Connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 37. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 37-yard line. Looking to throw. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Blake Jarwin, the intended receiver. And it's second down. Line of scrimmage again, the 37, as they line up second and 10. They'll set up a throw. The open man here, Renfro. And
hey, Renfro.
Into the end zone.
Look at my clutch.
Touchdown. Hunter Renfro.
We'll take it. All right, let's go. Oh, look what just happened.
Ready.
Oh, my God. Where are we?
50 to Mike. Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up. Let's go.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well. They'll look to throw here. He's going to air one out. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
You owe me 2 yards.
Running is Jacobs. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Yeah, see ball, get ball.
He'll look to throw. He's got a man open. It's Hunter. throw. And they work this well upfield across the 45. They'll set up to throw. How about this first quarter for them throwing the football?
This defense has zero answers for what they've seen so far with the ball in the air. I'm not sure how they're going to change things around, but offensively, I keep attacking. I keep throwing the football until they make me change.
Oh, I'm running.
Back to throw now on second and 10. This to Jarwin. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 28. This quarterback now, 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Back to throw. Got an open man, it's Aikman. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
A quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers point their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Marcel Aikman, his second touchdown on the season.
Okay, this game is going better than I anticipated, and let's just try to ride that play a little while, Kelly.
They'll run on first down. It's Butler. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. On second down now, it's Jacobs. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They go play action here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about.
Yeah, that's me throwing the ball past line of scrimmage, which I didn't know you could actually do.
So they say no to the penalty. The incompletion stands. It'll be second and 10.
And what they want to do is go ahead and take those downs away from them. You never want to give extra snaps to any offense. That's how you get hurt.
Back to throw here. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Frank Clark, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. On play action, they'll throw. He's going to find and complete it to Renfro. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A pickup of 27. And they pick up the first down in the process. And now this pass brought in by Brown. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout. An injured player. We'll take a break and get a report from Oakland after this. This quarterback now over 200 yards already in this first half. It's first and 10. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Thank you so much for deciding to catch the ball.
A nice gain of 21 yards. And he's got it. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Hunter Renfro with his second.
That's right.
On first down, it's Jacobs. He is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a mullet.
Yeah. He rifles one that's intercepted. Darren Lee picks it.
Okay, that could have gone better. Mistakes were made. And we have you on the edges.
to the air here after the INT on the last drive. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick. Right. And he's able to take this one back.
Okay, so we did have this game completely in the bag, and then I started doing things.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Open man is Uzama. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They'll drop to throw. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. He's airing it out for Williams, and that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. They'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And it's knocked away.
Okay,
and
should have done that, but that doesn't matter. Oh, great. Okay. Now, where were we on that whole scoring points relentlessly thing? Because that was really working out for us.
Sad Hut, 60 orange. I'm going to run you over.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Rolling to his right. His throw incomplete.
You idiot.
And now offensively, it's 3rd and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. Catch number 40 for him on the year. It's first down. Now back to throw.
Gotta love the catch. I think you got to love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They're becoming a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are, and I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing. I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 32-yard line.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now you can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. They'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. That one good for 26 and a first down. Back to throw again. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown. Blake Jarwin, his third.
Okay. God.
Here we go, here we go.
Okay, let's really freak him out, shall we?
They'll run on first down. Jacobs. And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of 4.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
2nd and 6. Got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we Come up on first and 10. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. The tight end, C.J. Uzama, the intended receiver, and it's third down. The Raiders on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. He'll buy some time right. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on 3rd down.
Great.
So instead of...
Oh, awesome. Now we're totally losing. Okay.
Here we go. Set.
Well...
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Try to lay one up deep. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's 2nd down. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. 2nd and 10. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. Looking to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year and the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Hunter Renfro.
All right. Now, if our defense can come through... Oh, hey, look at this.
Red, 8-3. Watch the screen, watch the screen. And go.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. This to Jarwin. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A Raider first down, 17 yards. Well, that's a good first step. But several steps still to go.
They still have time for the possible game-winning field goal. Time for them to be quick and hurry at the same time.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete. Line of scrimmage again, the 37, as they line up 2nd and 10. They look to throw. Al Wright completes it to Jarwin. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
All right, we'll try that same damn play again.
They'll set up a throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
All right, now we got some run plays to run.
On first down, it's Jacobs. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. As they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. 2nd and 9 now. They'll roll him out right. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And this is gonna wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a 3rd down. 3rd and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or drape all over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. And if you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback and then make sure you blanket the field.
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
Okay, kick it. I understand. I won't take it personally, and they will go ahead and tie the game because I'm an idiot.
Set, ready.
So I guess it's overtime then.
They go play action here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete.
All right, 555 yards passing. That's fantastic. Get points, break the tie. Oh my God, okay.
Second and two. Blitz coming and down he goes. The sack comes from Anthony Hitchens. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. They'll look to throw here. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
All right, let's get their attention.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settle it, because you're trying to get to the end zone.
And this will be caught. Touchdown.
Oh, hey, look
at that. They needed overtime to get it done, but put this one in the win column.
It finally happened.
Great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get 4 quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted 4 quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for the Raiders, the final 2 weeks are going to tell the story for them as they move to 9-5 with a win. And they'll get another home date next week as the Jaguars will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Chiefs, this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos.
Okay, so it looks like next week we're going to the playoffs, or we're not. Just depends. So how many yards do I have? Oh, almost 4,500. But yeah, so things are happening, and I won an overtime game, so yeah. Are you terrified? Because I am.